Hey guys, Mishmi back again with another video. Today we got my week 4 match in the Pokemon World Domination against James, captain of the Tokyo Toxapex. So let's not waste any time and set this battle up. I'm a little nervous. I'm 1-2 so far. So let's hope I could get another win following my last one against David. So let me just put in the code, let him know I'm searching. And yeah, so James, his team, he has Aegislash, Bronzong, Farfetch'd, Copperajah, Hatterene, Quagsire, Crawdaunt, Excavalier, Indeedee Mail, and Bicovolt. So looking at his team, he is really weak to fire, so I brought a lot of fire types. I didn't bring a lot of fire types, but you know, I have a couple fire types. Let me just make sure. Oh, I have to actually set up my battle team here. Okay. So let's look at my team. If I could run. Okay, so here we go. We got Stinky, the Garbodor. Let me just change the moves. So yeah, he does have max speed. No, I want to get off my Toxic Spikes and Spikes again. I'm Stomping Tantrum just to have a ground move. Poison because he has the Hatterene. Corviknight, regular. Raybird Roost, Body Press, Defog. Nothing too crazy. Keldur, he does have the Fire Punch and Earthquake, you know, a couple fighting type attacks. Arcanine. Have Galvantula for webs to slow some stuff down, get a little poison off, and also for his Crawdaunt and just Crawdaunt, actually. Gengar also, Beast Choice Scarf, so, and Modest, so. Here we go, game one versus James. Let's see who he decided to bring. So James has his Copperajah, Bronzong, Bicovolt, Quagsire, Hatterene, and Bronzong. Did I miss something? So definitely looking good on my part, bringing, you know, the fire types and the ground types, fighting types. I'm thinking he's gonna want to lead off with Copperajah, and I would love to get off my either webs or my rocks. I also, since I'm expecting him to lead that, I could also just lead Arcanine. Arcanine kind of handles his team pretty well, except for the Quagsire, so I might just want to come in and Flare Blitz that off. I don't see any real useful Corviknight. Except for like defogging stuff away, so yeah, let me lead off with Arcanine this time. Maybe I should lead for him too. So frustrating. He has a lot of steel types too. My Garbodor isn't that good. Let's go Arcanine. Hello? I got it. Oof. I'm a little nervous. Let's see who he led with. Okay, so he did lead with his Bronzong. I'm expecting him to either set up a Trick Room or go for his Rock Song. Oh my god, they did not do it. Okay, so I'm expecting him to be levitate. Damn it, bro! I really thought I had my Arcanine. All right, so let's go for the T spikes. There I am, faster, and I really cannot touch this man with my Garbodor. Man, okay, so he goes for Stealth Rocks. have my defog overnight for that. So yeah, I'll just set up here. I'm expecting him to rack this spin though. I wonder if he is levitate. Does Bronzong get rapid spin? Ah. Yo, that Arcanine thing is really kidding me. Alright. See if he can spin. Okay, so you go for the Zen Headbutt. I do live that. I'm gonna get a little speed boost. So he gets a crit. If he goes, he does have the, he does have rapid spin. I'll see it on the next one. Kind of want to test if he's levitate also. I'll just go for another layer of spikes here. Definitely wish I had explosion. I took that off first actually. Okay, so he goes for the trick room. I'll just get my last spikes up then. Okay, so he switches out from Bronzong, goes into Paparazzo. Gonna take some spike damage. And now that he set up the Trick Room, I do see that Paparazzo is faster than me. So I'll just go for a Stomping Tantrum. He'll probably get the KO here, maybe even Dynamax. Okay, so he goes straight by Iron Head. Not sure if anything will be slower. I think I just go Corviknight here. Maybe, yeah, just Corviknight and go for the body press. He probably has Heat Crash. Oh man. Airway. I might want a Dynamax body press. Dynamax here. Stop his Paparazzo because I know he's gonna go for that the Heat Crash. I'll Dynamax Max Knuckle just to eat the attack. Oh, he Dynamax also. Okay. I did not expect this to Dynamax. I am slowing. I do not think Corviknight can take a max player from a Paparazzo. God, my computer is really slow, but okay, so you go for the Rock Fall. That much damage. Oh, so his Paparazzo is Light Orb. Get off my Max Knuckle. He does some damage. Here, I wanna go for the Max Guard to stall out his Trick Room and also. Okay, so we're back to normal on the dimensions, which is really good for me. I'll just go for another Max Knuckle. Get some damage off on this Paparazzo. Not picking up the KO here, but that's fine. I am at plus 2 with my Corviknight now. Just go straight for Rock Ball. Up to Life Orb, like I said. So now that both our Dynamaxes are over, I'm just gonna go with expecting him to die from Life orb. His next attack. I just need to see it. I'm not sure when I want to defog, or maybe I might just keep up the rocks because I also have three layers of spikes on his side and poison spikes. So he withdraws without his Bronzong. So it looks like his Bronzong is definitely Levitate. I'm expecting him to go for the Trick Room here and maybe go out to his Hatterene. So I'll just go for the body press, get some damage off. Okay, so he does go for the Trick Room. On this turn, just go for the Brave Bird. Expect him to switch out to something else. See who he goes. Oh, I did not record. Okay, so he goes out to Viking Bolt. Like I said, I did go for that, the Brave Bird. I'm expecting him to switch. Let's see how much damage he does. It might be... Okay, so... It lives pretty well. I thought it was gonna die. Just thinking about what he might go for here. I don't think that Corviknight dies or anything. Let's go for another Brave Bird. Okay, so he goes for Thunderbolt. Oh my god, that does an immense amount of damage. KOing my Corviknight. And his Viking Bolt is Life Orb also. I might want to just go... Yeah. Volkong Kelder. I'm gonna Drain Punch. Since I do know he's faster than me, I'm gonna take some damage. Hopefully, I shouldn't die since I am a Assault Vest, and then whatever he damages me with, I'll just try to cover that back. Oh my god, Life Orb Vital Bolt is doing too much damage. Next time I'm just gonna have to go for that Mob Punch because I did not expect to take that damage. That. Was it? Not barrage. Alright, so right now it is 4-6. He goes straight out to his Hatterene. Know it's faster. He might go for the Calm Mind. Is poison here. Let's see who do I need. Oh, sorry. Alright, so Margronine is still looking good. I have Vanguard for his Quagsire and his Indeedee. I'm just gonna have to handle with Galvantula, so I'll just sack Conkeldurr here. I'm expecting him to go for a maybe a Calm Mind. I don't think he's gonna go for the. Okay, so he just goes for Psychic here. Okay, on my Conkeldurr, that's fine. I should have checked to see how much the game is up for. Just use Galvantula. Okay, so Trick Room is over. I'm gonna go out to I'll just go out to Arcanine. He goes Arcanine. If I go Arcanine, I'm expecting him to switch out to Quagsire, but maybe I should just let that happen. Or I could go out to Gengar here and just go for the Shadow Ball. Yeah, I think that's a better play. Go to Gengar and Shadow Ball. Let me just check this team once again. Yeah, Shadow Ball should do a pretty good amount of damage. Unless he goes out to DD. I think it's Psychic and Normal. So it won't hit. Yep, Psychic and Normal. If he goes out to NDD, good play on him. I am Choice Scarf, which is kind of a waste since he has a really slow team. Write that down. Battery. KOs. Health. Yeah. It's actually pretty funny because we did a trade for Hatterene and Gengar this week. Alright, so I'm surprised he stayed in, allowing Gengar to KO his Hatterene. Yeah, now I'm locked into Shadow Ball. If he goes out to NBD, I can't do anything. Okay, so he just goes out to Bronzong. Probably going to go for another Trick Room. They are just staying and go for the Shadow Ball. I don't think it'll KO. Hopefully it does. Should have been Choice Specs. Oh my god, Bronzong living on a pinch of health. As he goes for the Trick Room, let's see, I don't want to stay in here because I know I'm slower. He's probably going to go for a Zen Headbutt and KO me, so I'm just going to switch out to Galvantula here. Yeah, definitely just going to go out of Galvantula. So yeah, too bad. Maybe I should have bled Galvantula. It looks like for the series, my Galvantula would just be used as a sack or maybe a pivot because I don't see it really doing anything in our games. Kind of like Garbodor. Although Garbodor could have handled Hatterene pretty well. Okay, so he just goes for the Earthquake. That's good. Okay, so Galvantula lives that pretty well, burning off a turn of the Trick Room. I just missed the KO. Okay, so Trick Room. I don't think he's gonna live this next Earthquake. Just go through that. Yeah. Two turns of Trick Room left. And I have my Gengar and Arcanine. Alright, so I'm pretty sure Arcanine can live a, Arcanine can live a Earthquake. Oh my god, those Intimidate is gonna allow him to also take a hit. Let me write that down. Well, I'll write it down in between. At minus one, I know I definitely live. So I'm just gonna go for the Morning Sun, expecting him to Earthquake or whatever. Let's see. Yeah, okay, so he goes for the Earthquake. Bronzong. KOs. Bronzong KOs. We're definitely not out of this match yet. Now I'll just go for the Close Combat. Or maybe I should go for the Morning Sun again. Because, alright, so let's say I go for the Morning Sun again, but he switches out. Now, my Arcanine is up against his Quagsire, which I definitely don't want. Or, I go for the Close Combat, and he switches out. He stays in, I go for Close Combat. This is the last turn of Trick Room. Just go for. I'll go for the Close Combat here. Ah, damn it! All right, so I definitely should have went for the Morning Sun on that last turn to keep my Arcanine healthy. because as we can see, her trick room ends here. And I do pick up the KO. It does drop my defense. It was either that or taking a little bit of damage. And I am life orb, so my Arcanine is really low. He just goes out to Quagsire here. Yeah, I should have definitely gone for the Morning Sun. Should have definitely led Arcanine. Write that down. Since I was in DD. This trick room too? No way. No way. Do I go for the Morning Sun, or do I go for the Flare Blitz? Alright. And Gengar. Alright, so Energy Ball from Gengar should KO those other two mons. I'm just gonna go straight for the Flare Blitz. See what happens. Alright, so Arcanine KOs his ability. He's gonna have to go out to Quagsire here. I think I'm gonna lose the time, but or I could switch out. I might have my Arcanine doesn't do anything here. Let me go for the close combat. Alright, that should put him in range to Gengar's energy ball. Gengar is Choice Scarf. So after Arcanine dies here, Energy Ball should KO Quagsire and Copperajah. Well, Copperajah comes in on Spike, so it dies anyway. Quagsire KOs Arcanine. I might lose to time though. Okay, so there's 2 minutes left. As long as I pick my moves quick, I should be fine. So like I said, I just go out to Gengar, hit him with the energy ball. Come on. Gengar. Quagsire. And let's see what happens when he sends in Copperajah. Pretty sure that's a spike. And yes! Alright, so Copperajah dies to spikes from Garbodor. And that was game 1. I'll be back with game 2.